Welcome you all in the third session of paper presentation. The session is chaired by Dr. Javed Iqbal. Dr. Iqbal did his bachelor's from University of Jammu, master's that's MSc, master's of philosophy that's MPhil, and doctorate that's PhD from Aligarh Muslim University. Presently, he is working as senior assistant professor in the Department of Mathematical Sciences, BGSB University, Rajouri, Jammu and Kashmir. He has more than 15 years of teaching and research experience. He has successfully guided 10 MPhil and 5 PhD theses. Dr. Iqbal is a highly cited author and has published more than 50 research articles in national and international journal of repute. And I feel honored to share with you all that he is my PhD supervisor. With this, I welcome Dr. Iqbal. Over to you, Javed Iqbal, sir.
Thank you, Arthur. It's my privilege and honor to chair this session. First, I would like to thank the organizer, especially Dr. Aziz Raina, Cape Comorin Trust, and other organizing member of this international conference, today's international conference. So I will know, being a chairperson of this session, so I'm also extend this welcome to the this participant of this session. First one is the MJ Abisha. Abisha, you are Abisha, you are present?
Yes, sir.
Please keep in your mind that you have to cover the whole presentation within 5 to 6 minutes, as per the this is announcement of the organizing secretary and convener. So please keep this in your mind and start your presentation on the title. K Lemmer 3 means labeling of disconnected graphs. So go ahead.
Wait 7 minutes. Sir, can my slide visible?
No.
Yes, now visible.
Okay, thank you, sir. I am Abisha MJ, research scholar, Department of Mathematics, St. Jude's College, Tuttur. My topic is K Lechmer 3 mean labeling of some disconnected graphs under the guidance of K Rubin Mary, ma'am. Introduction: graph theory is the study of various graphs and can be used to model many structures in the real world. Graph theory has experimented a fast development during the last 30 years. Graph theory increasingly finds that many of their problems can be solved on their research furthered by the use of computing technologies. Graph labeling is one of the fast growing areas in graph theory. Labeling graphs provide mathematical models for a broad range of applications such as coding theory, X-ray, crystallography, radar, communication networks. Graph labeling is an assignment of integers to the vertices or edges or both, subjected to the certain conditions. A vertex labeling of graph G is an assignment H of labels to the vertices of G that induces each edge XY a label depending on the vertex label H of X and H of Y. Several variations of graph labeling such as graceful, square, sum, cardial, mean, etc. have been introduced by several authors. Graphs described here is simple, undirected and connected graphs. Let V of G and E of G be stated as the vertex and edge set of graph G. We refer Galien for more comprehensive survey. We follow Harari for some standard words, expressions and symbols. The concept and notations of mean labeling was first introduced by S. Somasundaram and R. Ponraj. S. Somasundaram, S. Sandhya and T. Pavitra introduced the concept of Lechmer 3 mean labeling. Here we investigating some standard graphs in K. Lechmer 3 mean labeling of some disconnected graphs. Definition: let G be a R, S graph. A function H is called Lechmer 3 mean labeling of graph G. If it is possible to label the vertices V belongs to V with distinct label H of X from 1, 2, 3, etc. S plus 1 in such a way that when each edge E equal to XY is labeled with H of E equal to ceiling of H of X cube plus H of Y cube divided by H of X square plus H of Y square, or flooring of H of X cube plus H of Y cube divided by H of X square plus H of Y square, then the edge labels are distinct. In this case, H is called Lechmer 3 mean labeling of graph G. Second, K Lechmer 3 mean graph. Definition: let G be a R, S graph. A function H is called K Lechmer 3 mean labeling of graph G. If it is possible to label the vertices V belongs to V with distinct label H of X from K plus 1, K plus 2, etc., K plus S in such a way that each edge E equal to XY is labeled with H of E equal to flooring H of X cube plus H of Y cube divided by H of X square plus H of Y square, or ceiling H of X cube plus H of Y cube divided by H of X square plus H of Y square, then the edge labels are distinct. A graph which admits a K Lechmer 3 mean labeling is called K Lechmer 3 mean graph. There is the example for K Lechmer 3 mean graph. Here in K we put 20. Therefore in vertices, the condition is we have to put K, K plus 1, etc. Here K equal to 20. Therefore 20, 21, etc. Then the vertex we have to label by using the formula H of E equal to flooring H of X cube plus H of Y cube divided by H of X square plus H of Y square. Then we get the edge label. Then the condition is the vertex and the edge label should be of distinct. In this comb graph PN corona K1, the condition satisfies. Therefore, K Lechmer 3 mean labeling admits the corona graph. Then the main theorem: PM union PN corona K1 is a K Lechmer 3 mean graph. Here we put K 50. Then this condition also satisfies for K Lechmer 3 mean graph. The next theorem: PM corona K1 union PN corona K1 comma 2 is a K Lechmer 3 mean graph. Then next theorem: PM union PN corona K1 corona K1 comma 2 is a K Lechmer 3 mean graph. The next theorem: PM corona K1 union PN corona K1 is a K Lechmer 3 mean graph. Next theorem: PM corona K1 comma 3 union PN is a K Lechmer 3 mean graph. Here is some reference. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Bisha. Any question from the participant? Abhisha, it was a nice presentation, but keep one thing in your mind next time. Please rotate your presentation while presenting the your presentation is not moving accordingly as per your title and what are you reading. So keep this thing next time in your mind.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Welcome. So next presentation is that is Mayank Singh.
Hello,
Mr. Mayank Singh.
Well, hello.
Yes.
Yes,
so,
sir.
So your present your topic is that transmit analysis of MIQ with catastrophes, rebound, and discouragement. So present your topic within 5 to 6 minutes.
Yes.
Sorry,
is my PPT is visible?
Yes, it is visible.
Good evening all, myself Mayank Singh. I am a research scholar from Department of Mathematics, IIT Roorkee. The title of my presentation is Transient Analysis of MMQ with Catastrophe, Reboot and Discouragement. These are the three main features that we have included in our queuing system. Catastrophe in queuing system means that the loss of all the customer at sudden, which means all the customer that are present in the system are lost at once and the queue get disturbed. Reboot means in imperfect covering, we see that when the fault is not successfully covered by the system itself, then it can be removed by the reboot process. Discouragement in queuing system is occur when the queuing system is not working or working with the slower rate, then the customer in the system may get discouraged and leave the queue without getting the service. In literature review, Jain and Singh used an MM1 queue with feedback, discouragement and disaster and obtained the transient analysis of the system. And also in 2010, Sudesh used MM1Q with customer impatient and disaster to obtain the transient analytical formula with the help of continued fraction and probability generative function method. Also Oppenheimer et al. Study why do internet service fail and what can be done about it, and in this finding we see that the main cause of the internet server failure is operator failure, and there are many other things that the internet service fail. So this is my model description. I will describe my model with the help of this diagram. So we can see that there are three states of the system. Downwards is normal busy state. We can see that the customer arrive to the system with rate lambda and are served by a single server with rate mu. Also we can see that in normal busy state the system can suffer a catastrophic failure with rate delta from each node. Here we can see that, and after the occurrence of the failure the system goes to the down state. After the failure there are two possibilities. One is that when the fault is successfully covered, then it is repaired by a repairman. If it is not, then it is cleared by a reboot process and the system goes to the reboot process. Also we can see that in down state we can allow the customer to join the system, but there is no service. Therefore, in the down state, the customer may get leave the queue without getting the service with the rate tau. Tau is our drainaging rate. So by balancing the inflow and outflow to the each node, we get the equation number 1 to 6. From equation number 2, we can see that equation number 2 is in terms of three-term recurrence relation. So it can be easily solved by the method of continued fraction. Equation number 3 and 4 are solved by the method of probability generative function, and equation number 5 and 6 directly solved by taking the Laplace transform and then inverse Laplace transform of these equations. So using the method of continued fraction in equation number 2, we get the value of P0 and T in form of HNT and P00T. Also we can see that the P00T is explicitly written in the form of the system parameter. Also the HNT is written in the form of C and D, where C and D are written in the form of the system parameters. Now from the equation number 3 and 4 are solved by the PGF. So this is GTZ is our generative function to generate the probabilities P1 and T. So by solving the equation, we get P1 and T as in equation number 10. Also, equation number 5 and 6 are directly solved by taking the Laplace transform and then inverse Laplace transform of the system of these equations. So we see that here R is expressed in term of P00T and Rn is expressed in term of P0NT. The P0NT is obtained by here, and P0T is stated explicitly. So now we can obtain the numerical solution of the system. So we use MATLAB software and use the default parameter as this, and we obtain the numerical result in the form of these graphs. So in these figure 1 and 2, we see that ENT varies with respect to lambda increasingly and decreases with respect to mu. Mu is our service rate, and lambda is our arrival rate. Also, the PWT, which is the probability that the system is in working state, is also increases when we increase the value of gamma. Also, probability that the system will be in down state is decreased when we increase the value of gamma. Also, the probability that the system is in reboot state is obtained by the two values of sigma, which is sigma equal to 0.5 and sigma equal to 0.3. Now the throughput, the effective service rate of the system is also obtained. Here we can see that as we increase the value of service rate, the throughput is also increased. And also, if we increase the value of sigma, then the TST is also increased. So in this study, we have studied an MM1Q with reboot, discouragement, and catastrophe. And we successfully apply the method of probability generative function and continued fraction to obtain the transient analytical formula. So these are our references. Thank you.
Thank you, Mike. Any question from the participant? So if there is no question, so thanks to the speaker for such a nice presentation, very beautiful organized and very beautiful present. Thank you once again. So moving ahead, next presenter is the Eunice Alex, AL Eunice Alex, Miss Eunice Alex.
Hello, sir.
So title of your presentation is Complementary Sign Edge, Total Domination Numbers in Graphs. Go ahead with your presentation.
Okay, sir. Is my screen is visible?
It's visible.
Okay, sir. Myself, AL Eunice Alex. Resource scholar under the guidance of Dr. Y.S. Aaron Sheila, Department of Mathematics, Scott Christian College, Nagercoil. My topic is Complementary Signed Edge Total Domination Numbers in Graph. First outline of the presentation, introduction, definition, main results, conclusion, and future works, refreshing. First one, introduction. By a graph, We mean a finite, undirected, connected graph without loops or multiple edges. The concept edge domination was introduced by Mitchell and Hedinkee. Further, the concept was extended to define other edge parameter like sine edge domination, which was introduced by Bichu in the year 2001. Bieselinger was introduced the concept of the sine edge total domination number in the year 2002. In this paper, we introduce complementary sine edge total domination number and find some results for graphs. Definition: let G be a graph, a function f from E of G to minus 1, 1 is called a complementary sine edge total dominating function of G if it is satisfied summation E dash not belongs to open neighborhood of E, f of E dash greater than or equal to 1 for every E belongs to E of G. The weight of F is defined as W of F is equal to summation E belongs to E of G, f of E. The complementary signed edge total domination number is defined as gamma dash CST of G is equal to minimum of W of F such that F is a complementary signed edge total domination function of G. Here one example, consider the graph G. In this graph, edges are E1, E2, E3, E4, and E5. Define F from E of G to minus 1 plus 1. Assign the values E of E1, E2, E3, E4 is equal to 1. And the edge E5 is equal to minus 1. Then to find F of W of F, that is weight of F, is equal to summation of all edges, that is equal to 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 minus 1, that is equal to 3. That is the complementary signed edge total domination number of this graph is equal to 3. Then main results. For the path Pn with n greater than or equal to 3, the complementary signed edge total domination number is equal to, if n is even, then the value is 3. If n is odd, then the value is 4. Next one, for the cycle Cn with n greater than or equal to 3, the complementary signed edge total domination number of Cn is, if n is odd, the value is 3. If n is even, then the value is 4. Next one, star graph. For the star graph and n greater than or equal to 1, the complementary signed edge total domination number for this graph is equal to n. Next one, the comb graph CBN, that is equal to PN corona K1 and n greater than or equal to 2. The complementary signed edge total domination number for this graph is gamma dash CST of CBN is equal to 3. Next one, for the friendship graph FN and n greater than or equal to 3, the complementary signed edge total domination number of Fn is, if n is odd, then the value is 3. If n is even, that is equal to 4. Conclusion and my future works. In this paper, we obtained some results related to complementary signed edge total domination number for certain graphs. And this works gives the scope of an extensive study of various domination parameters of this graph. We have planned to extend the paper for some algebraic graphs. These are my reference. Thank you.
Thank you. Any question from participant? So thanks, Liksa. It was a nice presentation, very nice and comprehensive presentation. And Thank you once again. So next presenter is Dr. Sapna Sharma. Dr. Sapna Sharma, go ahead with your presentation with the title Transit Analysis of Two Heterogeneous Servers Queuing System with Customer Impatience and Retention. Dr. Sapna, go ahead.
Sir, I think she's not present.
Okay. So if Dr. Sapna is not present, so next presenter is the Miss Sasri. Miss Sasri.
Yes, sir.
Yes, she's present.
So Sasri, present your presentation.
Okay.
Title is Subspatial Laplacian Matrix of Power 3 Means Graph. So go ahead with your presentation.
Sir, visible my presentation?
No.
Can you visible, sir?
Yes.
Yes. Good evening to all. And Saraswati, research scholar, Sri Ayyappa College for Women, Chungangade, under the guidance of Dr. S. Sandhya. My topic is some special Laplacian matrix of power 3 mean graphs. Introduction. In mathematical field of graph theory, the Laplacian matrix is otherwise called the graph Laplacian. Laplacian matrix can be helped to find several properties of a graph. It will be used to calculate many different properties of a graph. A brief survey of graph labeling we referred by J.A. Gallien and Harari. The concept of harmonic labeling was first introduced by Somasundaram and Dr. S. Sandhya, and further the study developed a modified work by S. Sandhya and Sriji introduced power 3 mean labeling of graphs. This above work is motivated by me to do this work. We introduced and developed a new type of concept called Laplacian matrix of power 3 mean graphs. This is the notation G symbol graph V of G vertex set of G is a edge set of G. This is the differential. At GBA power 3 mean graph, the Laplacian matrix LG is denoted by L of G is equal to D of G minus A of G, where D of G is denoted by diagonal matrix of the vertex degrees, and A of G is denoted by adjacent matrix. This is the remark. The element of each row and column represent the degree of corresponding vertex. Next remark is, in this Laplacian matrix of power 3 mean graph, there is no column and row with all elements are zero. This is the third one. Laplacian matrix of power 3 mean graph has no isolated vertices. This is the theorem. First theorem, Laplacian matrix of matrix G is L of G is equal to D of G minus A of G, where G is a bull graph. This is the diagram. This is D of G and L of G. This is the Laplacian matrix of bull graph. Next theorem is Laplacian matrix of diamond graph. Next one is fork graph. This is the conclusion. Study of Laplacian matrix is very useful for machine learning applications. This paper, we find bull graph, fork graph, diamond graph are some special graph of power 3 mean graphs. It is easy to derive the matrix representation of a graph. This is my reference. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks for nice presentation.
Thank you, sir.
Any question from the participant? Any question from the participants? So thanks once again, Sasri.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Next presenter is the Jitinder P. Patel. Jitinder, you are audible?
Yes, sir. I am audible.
So, yes. Go ahead with your presentation. Colon cancer detection, very, very important. Title is very important. Colon cancer detection challenges, issue and application. Hope all of us get benefited of your presentation.
Just wait, sir. I just share.
Okay. Go ahead with your presentation.
Sir, visible, sir, PPT, sir?
No.
Okay. Just wait, sir. Sir, visible PPT?
No. Yes, it is visible now.
Thank you, sir. Good evening to all. So today I am presenting a topic is colon cancer detection challenges, issue and application under the guidance of Dr. Tushar Jawre. KBC
not. Jitendra, your voice is not clearly audible.
I am audible, sir.
No, it's okay.
Yes, sir, I'm audible.
Yes. Okay, go ahead.
So, outline of this presentation is Introduction in short, research background, literature review, approaches, methodology, expected outcomes, and the references. So here, introduction to the colon cancer, that's called the colorectal cancer, is a type of cancer that being in a colon or rectum, which is located inside the large intestine. This is the biological images. Here, main four parts is important. Is the first one is the cecum, second one is the colon, third one the sigmoid colon, and the colon is divided into the three parts. So first one is the ascending, second one is the transverse colon, and third one is the descending colon. The cancer, colon cancer, as seen during the colonoscopy. This is the window we have to show. So, colorectal cancer. Cancer has been in a colon or rectum, which is located at the diagnostic tract lower end. Early cases can be being a non-cancerous polyp. This offer have no symptoms but can be detected by skinning. So the polyp is developed anywhere in a large intestine. There are two main categories of polyp: non-neoplastic, means non-cancerous polyp, and the neoplastic is the cancerous polyp. So signs and symptoms of colon is the colorectal cancer. Symptoms depend on the size and the location of the cancer. Here the include change in the bladder habits, change in the stool consistency, blood in the stool, abdominal discomfort, constant dryness, and the vomiting. This is the signs and symptoms. The treatment depends on the stages. Is the colorectal cancer treated depends on the size, locations, and how far the cancer has spread. Common treatment is including the surgery to remove the cancer, then the chemotherapy and the radiotherapy, and also one more we have to use the biological therapy, use the medicines. Then the global statistics, cancer is the second most fatal disease worldwide and the leading cause by nearly 1 in the 6 deaths globally. According to the approximate 8.8 PRC is the world's third most common cancer in terms of prevalence, 6.1% by the second in terms of the mortality. By 2030, the worldwide burden of a CRC is estimated by rise of 60% of respect to new cases. The colonoscopy seems to be the most trustful early detection method. So early cancer detection extends human life and aids to the fight against the diseases. Medical images is the useful tool to detection for the early and play an important part in the cancer treatment. Sorry. Despite the growth in the medical images, data interpreting the data in correction to illness progress speed to time consuming and challenging. So this highlights the critical needs to the automatic colon cancer screening technology that can be to identify colon cancer more reliable with also lower process time. One distinguished aspect of cancer is the fast formation of the abnormal cells that expand beyond their normal borders and can be subsequently infected neighboring sections of the body and migrate to the organs. So this process is known as the metastasis. The common, most commonly cause of cancer mortality is metastasis. So here the research background in that the colon is a key component to the large intestine, and cancer of the colon is a leading cause of mortality in the West and industrialized world. So this is the pathological stages for the stage 0 to stage 4. So cancer found only the inner most lining of a colon or rectum. This is the stage 0. Stage 1 is the inner wall and the colon or rectum. Stage 2 is the outside of nearest tissue, expected lymph nodes. Third, stage 3 is the lymph node, but not to be other part of the body. And stage 4 is the spread part of the other part of the body, trained to the extent for the livers or for a lungs. So the limitations of this, to begin with, subjective sense qualification, quantitative indicators such as the cancer grade stages rely heavily on pathological visualized judgment. Second, there is a grading variant between and among observation. Such flow of manual process necessarily to develop and of automatic colon cancer diagnostic process, which might be given pathology with a second opinion and act as the individual reliable method for the cancer identification. So here, as a result of reliable computing aids methods is needed to automatic categorize normal or cancerous colon sample as well as identify malignant sample grades. So here we have to use automatic detection of colon cancer. There are two main avenue of automatic detection. First one is the segmentation and second one is the classification. Segmentation according to the spatial distribution of tissue in the images, segmented divided into heterogeneous colon sample into homogeneous sections, and the classifications are their area are the labeled as normal and malignant depending on the specific characteristic due to the variety of characteristics including similar hue and variation biological element. Automatically categorize of a colon into the normal and malignant classification is difficult. So the literature review here, the five different methods to have to use. The first one is the spectral analysis, second one is the texture analysis, third one is the gene analysis, serum analysis, and the fifth one is the object oriented or OO texture analysis. So the here in that five methods, they are using three for work for the images. For one is the texture, hyperspectral, and OO textures. So here we have to show the texture analysis based techniques is the collection of regular and irregular repetition patterns. Normally and normal and cancerous column tissues have to consider different in texture which is being exploited in a approaches. Here we have to compare with the different authors and their outcomes. So Elkers, the subgray labels images of co-occurrence matrix GLCM of images is used to compute texture properties such as energy, inertia, and homogeneity. Same thing, the Kalkin and all use texture and automatic features to divide column sample into three categories: normal, precancerous, and malignant. Here they have to use the total 2000 patches per classes were utilized in the research work. The GO and L are used for the colon biopsy pictures are first transformed to grayscale scale images. In a study, the image are used to compute statistical characteristics such as mean and variance. So ANGI and L are preferred to the standard deviation, entropy, homogeneity, Kustoki, and skewness of pixel distribution homogeneous and contrast material enhanced CT images were returned. Then the or object-oriented texture analysis based techniques. Here we have to just analyze the different authors and their outcomes. This technique is used based on the information of colon tissue segmentation and categorize of colon biopsy pictures of a size and geographical distribution. This approach were featured separately into the techniques of segmentation and classification. The author first or the Somisar is and all is used for the OO segmentation is the first OO based segmentation methodology based on a texture analysis that encompass three stages: normal object definition, texture definition, and segmentation, and comparing the three well defined phases. The Tosam and all is the group of 12 features of utilized as a computer for each items during the feature extracting phases. GKM and all is used for the MO segmentation. There are some improvement of the segmentation approaches which is compatible for O segmentation and O texture analysis based classification techniques. The Dingbers is used to process the circular fitting is compatible of O segmentation with just an expecting for the location nucleus and object only people purple and white clusters. So here the hypertexture analysis based on the here we have to use hypertext analysis based approaches detection normal or malignant.
Mr. Patel, sorry for disturbance, please concise your presentation. We are lacking of time, so just show your methodology which you use for this.
Yes sir. Expected outcomes, the proposed research work will be used to the society and will help gastroenterologists for early detection and treatment for colon cancer in future. The research work given below, the able to develop automatic segmentation of cancer lysing by using the computer aided system, able to enhance cancer lysing detection for with accurate classification of cancer, determine extent of cancer and whole slide images and identify cancer with improved degree of accuracy and help. So this is a data set we have to prepare for paper 2003 and this is the references. Thank you, sir.
So any question from the participant? So if there is no question, thanks for presentation, Mr. Patel. So next presenter is the Shikna Henry. Shikna?
Yes, sir. I'm here.
Okay. So go ahead with your presentation. Yes, entitled Signed Total Domination Number of Order Divisor Graph of Some Finite Groups. So go ahead with your presentation.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Shekina Henry, research scholar from Scott Christian College, and I'm doing research under the guidance of Dr. Y.S. Irene Sheila. I'm here to present my paper, Signed Total Domination Number of Order Divisor Graph of Some Finite Groups. This is the outline of my presentation. It consists of five sections. First, I'll give a brief introduction about my topic and my subject and the objectives of my paper. Then I will explain about the definition with the examples. After that, I will give my important results. Finally, I conclude my presentation. My topic comes under the category algebraic graph theory. It is a branch that uses various techniques to connect vital branches of mathematics such as graph theory and algebra. The main branch mainly focuses on following three concepts: study of graphs in connection with linear algebra. This is called spectral graph theory. And the next is study of graphs in connection to group theory, study of algebraic properties of invariance of graphs. This paper comes under the category study of graphs in connection to group theory. Further, there are algebraic graphs constructed from algebraic structures such as groups, rings, etc. The purpose of the paper: the concept of sine total dominating function is first proposed by Selinger, and there is a graph order divisor graph of group which is constructed with the elements of group as vertices. We thought of giving an interconnection between these two concepts, sine total dominating function and the order divisor graph of group. So the aim of the paper is to find the sine total domination number of order divisor graphs of finite groups. Since group is a large area, we have limited the portion with integer modulo and dihedral groups. Sine total dominating function and sine total domination number. A sine total dominating function of a graph G is defined as a function f from V of G to minus 1 comma 1 such that it should satisfy the condition summation u belongs to open neighborhood of V, f of u greater than or equal to 1 for all V belongs to V of G. The sine total domination number for a graph G is gamma st of G equal to minimum of weight of f such that f is a sine total dominating function of G. Here weight in the sense sum of the function values of all the vertices of the graph. Here I have given an example. I have defined a function f from v of k 6 to minus 1 comma 1 in such a way that the vertices v2 and v4 are assigned minus 1 and the other vertices are assigned plus 1. Now when I take a vertex, the open neighborhood of v1 consists of v2, v3, v5, v6 and v4. Since only v2 and v4 are assigned minus 1, when we take the sum values of the open neighborhood, it will be 1, which is greater than or equal to 1. Hence, we can say that f is a sine dominating function and it is minimum, the weight of the function is 2. Order divisor graph of group. Let G be a finite group. This order divisor graph of a group, the vertex set of this graph consists of the elements of the group G and two distinct vertices A and D having different orders or adjacent if either order of A divides order of B or order of B divides order of A. I have given an example, the integer modulo 10. The order divisor graph of this group is given as, this is the graph obtained, this is the order divisor graph of integer modulo. I have mentioned the order of every element inside the brackets. For example, when we take the element 3, since the order of the element is 10, it is adjacent to every other elements except the elements having the same order 10. The important results: sine total domination number of order divisor graph of the group is 2p, where p prime is found as gamma st of OD of z2p equal to 2, and sine total domination number of order divisor graph of the group is 3p. For prime p, from odd prime p is gamma st of order divisor graph of z3p equal to 3. Let G be a group of order p power n, p prime integer, then the sine domination number of order divisor graph of the group is 1 if p power n is odd and 2 if p power n is even. For the group zp, p prime gamma st of od of zp equal to p. For a dihedral group with the n prime, gamma st of od of d2n equal to 2n. Conclusion: the paper gives an explanation about sine total dominating function and order divisor graphs of groups. In this paper, sine total domination number of the group zp of order 2p, 3p, p power n and p are found. Also, sine total domination number of dihedral group d2n for prime n is also determined. Future works, we have planned to extend the paper for other groups. Also, there is an idea of finding application of the paper in various fields. These are my references. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, sir.
Thanks for nice presentation, Shikna Henry.
It's a wonderful presentation, well organized, and thanks once again. Any question from the participant?
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
So thanks once again. If there is no question, so moving ahead. So next speaker is the
thank you, sir.
Miss Yami Yadav. Miss Yamini Yadav. I think she has not joined. Yamini Yadav. So next speaker is Dr. M. Kavaskar. I think he is not available. So next speaker is the LG Binoja. LG Binoja.
Yes, hello. Yes, present here.
Yes, so, sir.
Yes, LG Binoja. Go ahead with your presentation. Yes, sir.
Good evening. Good evening. Visible, sir.
Okay, go ahead with your presentation.
Good evening to all. My research topic is relatively plain detour domination number of a graph. My
Binoja, your presentation is not visible. First upload your presentation.
Visible, sir?
No, still not visible. Take few seconds and try to upload your presentation.
Yes, sir. Can visible, sir?
No, still not visible. Yes, sir, visible. Just zoom your presentation. Okay, go ahead.
Slideshow, ma'am, click on slideshow. Okay, go ahead, ma'am, go ahead. We're running out of time.
Today I am going to talk about my research topic is relatively prime detour domination number of a graph. First I talk about what is detour, what is domination and relatively prime dominating set. Let S be a set of vertices, S set S is set to be detour. If every vertices not in S lies on a longest path between two vertices from S. S set S is set to be dominating set if every vertex not in D has at least one neighbor in D. S set S subset of V is set to be relatively prime dominating set with at least two elements and for every pair of vertices U and V in S such that degree of U, degree of V is equal to 1. In this paper, we introduce relatively prime detour domination number of a graph. it is denoted by comma RPDN, RPDNRG. S is set to actually prime detour domination number of a graph if it is detour and dominating set with at least two elements and for every pair of vertices U and B such that degree of U comma degree of V is equal to 1. The minimum cardinality of a relatively prime detour dominating set is called relatively prime detour domination number of a graph and is denoted by comma RPDN of B. Consider the graph. In this graph, vertices 1, 3, comma 6 are the relatively prime detour domination set. Therefore, comma RPDN of G is equal to 3. Remark, every end vertex of a graph G belongs to every relatively prime detour dominating set of G. Theorem, if G is a star graph, then relatively prime domination number is equal to N. If G is a bistar graph, then relatively prime domination number is equal to MN. If G is a complete graph, then N is equal to greater than or equal to 2, then relatively prime detour domination number is equal to detour number is 2, 0 if N greater than 2. If G is a complete bipartite graph, then comma RPDN of complete bipartite graph is equal to 2 if M is equal to N is equal to 1 and M comma N is equal to 1 where M comma N greater than or equal to 2, N if M is equal to 1, N greater than or equal to 2, M if N is equal to 1, M greater than or equal to 2, 0 if M comma N not equal to 1 and M comma N greater than or equal to 2. If G is a Weil graph, then relatively prime detour domination number of a Weil graph is equal to 2 if N congruent to 1 mod 3, 0 otherwise. If G is a Helm graph, Hn, then comma RPDN of Hn is equal to N plus 1. Let G be a connected graph of order N. If comma RPDN of G is exist, then dn of g less than or equal to gamma rp dn of g less than or equal to n, where dn of g is a detour number. If g is a fan graph f 1 comma n, then gamma rp dn of 1, f of 1 comma n is equal to, yeah, if n is odd, then number is 2. If n is even, the number is 0. For n greater than or equal to 2, cn corona graph of k1, then gamma rp dn of this graph is equal to n. For n greater than or equal to 2, gamma RPDN of Pn corona k1 is equal to n. Next theorem, gamma RPDN of k1 is equal to n plus 1. These are my reference. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Ms. Bhandia. Yeah, I just repeat the participants. Once again, those who are not joined initially, Dr. M. Kavaskar. Ma'am, remove your presentation. Ms. Viroja, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Ma'am, remove your presentation.
Okay, sir.
Dr. M. Kavaskar. Ms. Mamni Yadav. No, I think there is no other speaker available in this session. So back to the Dr. Athiz Aziz Rana.
Thank you so much, sir, for your expert comments. Sir, am I audible?
Yes, yes. First of all, I would like to thank Athiz Aziz Rana and whole organizing team and also the Cape Korean Trust. I would also thank Professor A.K. Malak for supporting Dr. Athiz Aziz Rana and his team for organizing such a wonderful international conference. I feel proud and honored that one of my scholars
who is organizing this wonderful international conference, being in the government degree college Drahal, which is newly established college, and organizing such a wonderful conference. Is all credit goes to Dr. Atharji Jaina and his team. So I just once again congrats him, and also congrats Professor A.K. Malik sir for supporting Dr. Atharji Jaina and his team, and also Cape Coromandel Trust. So thanks once again. Go ahead,
Atharji. Thank you, sir, for your motivating words. It's really mean to me.